Must I imagine you there? Don't. What the fuck going on out here in these swamps?
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away.
Yeah. go on and save the Lord.
Let's go. Could I unwrap the marzipan slowly? A gift wrapped in rice paper. Or hold it in my mind, like a warm stone. I could feel the marzipan was delicate, smooth as silk, as I unwrapped it slowly. The rice paper stuck to my fingers. Its weight was light, but unmistakable. The crystal clear glaze looked almost like water as I held the marbleized almond in my hand, or rather, my mind. I imagined that it was warm stone, smooth and dense, rich with history and heavy with meaning. Its gaze returned my own. I couldn't believe what I was seeing, and it pulled me outside myself. I folded it hundreds of times to see how stable it would be. If it broke, would I feel the pale blue cascading? Could I follow that silver cord back to my astral body? Back, so to speak, again? A figure eight in the soft sand. A sleight of hand. A renewal in the arcing, bright light of morning. A nest is a cradle, is a prefix, is a birthing. Great gray emotional seat, nested like a pit in a cherry, pitted like water runs wet. Quaking soft shade of an aspen, an Inca dove in the sunset. Counting the points on a needle, waiting for rivers to flood. Ripening red fruit on the counter, quickening its mind with its blood. And could I unwrap the softening sky? Light peach on a still pond. Or give pause. like mugwort honeyed in amber. I could feel it was a safe space, with felted edges, as I looked for its center. The pond was lilting. Its sound was bright, but unmistakable. The horizon slipped fast and steep into the green. As I held the dawn chorus in my hands, or rather, my mind, I imagined that it was liquid opal, warm and slow, rich with history and heavy with questions. Its gaze returned my own. I couldn't believe what I was seeing, and it pulled me inside myself. I rotated it thousands of times to see how stable it was. If it gave, could I hear the splintering grass? Could I smell the sweet wood, ripening into life? Ripening, so to speak, again? A small birth. A quiet smile. A renewal in the arcing soft sky of morning. A splinter is a taste, is a graft, is a staple. Still, pink, unbending sky. Split like the water between us, breaking like bread on my lips. Soft as the wings of an angel, bearing a gauzy blue myth. Waiting a while for a ripple, widen with every new breath. Tracing the cold silver contours, spilling with light on the edge. And could I unwrap my second skin? A subtle Sunday molting. If not some new postures, then maybe new frames? I could feel the trick become a habit, like my love for linens, as I tried it on for size. My skin was tannic, its taste was thin, but unmistakable. The carbon composite almost seemed animate. As I held this miracle in my hands, or rather, my mind, I imagined that I was raw pearl, lusty and baroque, rich with history and ripe with power. Its gaze became my own. I couldn't separate our beings, and it pulled me inside itself. It rotated me millions of times to see how stable I was. If I shattered, would I feel the breaking edge? Would I fold neatly back into soil? Back, as it were, again? A vital loop. A spiky seed. A sacred inversion. A memory is a mirror, is a margin, is a meaning. Vital, green, unbreaking love, soar like a pulse tends to quicken, busting the clouds like a dove. Soft, winged emerald, uncaging, bright tilting earth from above. And could I unwrap a soft sound? A steep, bending yellow. Or hold it in my mind.
Je suis hors lit. On meurt tous à la fin du film. Si je te manque un jour, fais-moi un signe. Ma vision est grise. Y'a pas de méchants, y'a pas de gentils. Y'a que des gens dans leur vie qui veulent pas voir le prix. Mais tout a un prix. Ton âme comme tes habits. Je compte mon argent, mes amis. Compte pas sur moi, j'ai pas envie. Je ne veux plus te voir, tu ne vois pas assez loin. Le futur c'est pas loin, le futur c'est demain. Je ne veux plus te voir, même pas demain. Je ne veux plus te voir, tu ne vois pas assez loin. Je n'ai qu'un cœur. Je n'ai qu'un cœur, pas cette place. Je n'ai qu'un cœur, pas cette place. Je n'ai qu'un cœur, pas cette place. Tous les jours dans le lit, je me dis que la vie m'a pas repris. J'en ai pris, j'en ai repris. Ça a changé ma vie. J'ai peur de mourir, plus de vivre. J'ai besoin d'amour et vide. Un regard par la vitre. J'ai plus voulu sortir. Je ne veux plus te voir, tu ne vois pas assez loin. Le futur c'est pas loin, le futur c'est demain. Je ne veux plus te voir, même pas demain. Je ne veux plus te voir, tu ne vois pas assez loin. Je n'ai qu'un cœur, pas cette place. Je n'ai qu'un cœur. J'ai brisé la vitre et j'ai dansé comme si demain n'existait pas. Les yeux dans le vide,
I'm going to go to the next one. Dear Santa, I know it's getting close to Christmas and you're very busy, but I wanted to reach out and ask for a special gift. I've been very good this year, and all I want for Christmas is a Pop Ops toy. I've been dreaming of having one for so long, and I can't wait to play with it and show all my friends. Hey Santa, if you can make my wish come true, I would be so grateful. I know that you have a lot of children to take care of, but I promise to be extra good if you bring me Pop Ops toy. Thank you so much, Santa. I can't wait to see what you bring on Christmas morning. Alex.
I've been a very good boy this year, and all I want for Christmas is a Pop Ops toy. I've been dreaming of having them for so long, and I can't believe that you would just forget to bring it to me. I can't believe how unfair this is. I've been a very good boy all this year. All I ask is for one simple thing, but you've let me down. You've let me down and shattered all my dreams. I don't know what to do, Santa. I'm so very angry and disappointed. Please, I beg of you, bring me my Pothole's toy. I don't want anything else for Christmas. I just want one thing that I have been wanting for so long. Please, Santa, make this right. I'm counting on you to bring my Pothole's toy. I don't want to face Christmas morning without it.
I'm really stuck on this song.
Come on, go Betty!
You hear music, they hear...
Noise! Noise!
You create your own symphony.
Or rather than that.
It's you.
Almost any effort is well worth it.
This film takes you on a journey. A journey through the centuries and through the countryside, among fields and farms, hills and trees and rivers. It tells the peoples of five countries, Belgium, Britain, France...
Dear Alex, I hope this letter finds you well. I received your letters, and I am sorry to hear that you were disappointed about having never received a Pothole toy for Christmas. I know how much you were looking forward to it every year, and I can only imagine how disappointed it must have been for you. I want you to know that I do my best to fulfill every child wish, but sometimes it gets impossible. I have to take into account many factors, including the availability of certain toys, the number of children who have asked for the same thing, the logistics of delivering all of the gifts, and whether the toys exist in the first place. The Pothole toys do not exist, so I was unable to get my hands on any. I know that this may be difficult for you to hear, but I promise that I have something else in mind for you. This year, to the need of a Pothole toy, I will be bringing you a Pothole toy. It is a similar toy, and I think you will enjoy it just as much. I know that it isn't exactly what you asked for, but I hope that will bring you just as much joy and happiness. I want to assure you that I will do everything in my power to make sure that you have a wonderful Christmas. I will be visiting your house on Christmas Eve, and I hope to see you there. Until then, I want you to remember that I am always here to help and listen. If you need anything, please don't hesitate to reach out to me.
France, the Netherlands, and Luxembourg came to see and know their native lands through the eyes of great artists. The story...
Metsubou no yami ga... yomigaetta...
Thank you.
Allô? Allô, Lily? J'ai fait un daydream que seul toi peux comprendre. On rentre de mon cours d'escrime. Je suis divisée comme un split screen. Je mange une glace à la crème en pensant à Adam. Sur mon lit, je fais une folie. Je fume là, je regarde mon écran à liker ces messages. Ce sont des émojis. Se divise en fractales comme un diamant. J'ai fait un daydream. Allô? Allô, Lily? Je suis une machine. Rien ne me chagrine. L'adrénaline câline mes sentiments. Attends, puis toi, tu imagines l'amphétamine dans ma poitrine. Je suis cristal à feu et à sang. Attends, puis toi, je chasse le spleen. Un algorithme spécifique. J'ai du chagrin. Rien de fantastique. In dry. Copier-coller. Oh, solitude. My sweetest choice.
Just quatre canines en pointe taillée bien plantée. Tu as même une ou deux dents en acier brillant. Ça laisse quelques coups. Je pense que c'est tout. Sur mes babines, si un baiser peut.
Jump, 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 jump. Indicated the possibility of artificial intelligence by the year 2000. What do you mean by that?
Many computer scientists think that we will develop, before the end of the century, machines which are intelligent by any way you care to define that word. In fact, there are some...
In a 1968 letter to Science magazine, sci-fi author and futurist Arthur C. Clarke relayed his third and most famous law, that any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. Music, the art of the muses, has long played such tricks, haunting mankind since its dawn. Werwerquiotl, the Aztec god of music, mischief and deception, took the form of a dancing coyote with human hands and feet. A trickster, a shapeshifter, a storyteller. Apollo, the Greek god of music and knowledge, played a golden lyre, but was challenged to a musical duel by Pan, the wild, rustic, satyr-hoofed god of nature and fertility, in a contest that could only be judged by King Midas. Daniel Ek, the Swedish co-founder and CEO of Spotify, has after many years endowed music streaming with an omniscient, benevolent power of its own.
At Spotify, we really want you to democratic ally win us our musician. We want you to win because your music is the best music.
But this story, a story about music and technology, the Cain and Abel of entertainment, starts long ago. In the Middle Paleolithic period, hidden in a mountainous forested land that we now call Slovenia. Unearthed in 1995, the 40,000-year-old Divya Babe flute, also known as the Neanderthal flute, was once carved out of a cave bear's femur, pierced by holes to divide air into a pleasing sequence of notes. Music is in our bones, and our primeval voices echoed through the caves and underground chambers of Earth. Over millennia and centuries, tombs turned into temples and temples turned into cathedrals, bringing our long reverberating human voice one step closer to heaven. Before long, even our choirs were overpowered. The magnificent pipe organ extended our range with its bellows and foot pedals, and it was only a matter of time before the keyboard was perfected and mechanized for the benefit of civilization's great dynasties. Enter Bartolomeo Cristofori, the Italian craftsman and keeper of the instruments for the Medici family at the beginning of the 18th century. He built them a keyboard of cypress wood with soft and loud, the pianoforte. With its ingenious hammers and dampers, the piano finally gave solo musicians control over scale, dynamics, and power. Meanwhile, composers were amassing their own private armies, the vast orchestras of Europe, from 10 musicians to 30 to 60 to over 100 players, divided into strings, woodwind, brass, and beyond. Wood and metal, mallets and air, a cauldron of perfectly tuned materials, following the whims of composers and conductors, channeling the art of the muses back from the royal courts and into the public sphere. A multi-sensory spectacle of mass entertainment. As we steamrolled towards modern times, Wagner, the infamous 19th century ringmaster and composer, used the new textures of the orchestra to envision the Gesamtkunstwerk, the total artwork which would unify our artistic universe through opera and drama. Words, music, theatre, stagecraft, and magic collided in front of a dazzled audience. It was the beginning of multimedia as we know it. From microphone to studio to microprocessor, every instrument from human history can now be replicated, sampled, or modelled by the most ordinary computer. Even Wagner's orchestra has become a pale shadow compared to Apple's GarageBand or even Microsoft's Songsmith.
DOA, Death of Auto-Tune.
All I heard was Auto-Tune and death. That's all I heard. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, of course, that's, you know, it's my technique. That's what I'm known for. So when I hear death of that, it's like, wow.
Your technique is like death of T-Pain.
Yeah, almost. You know what I'm saying?
Auto-Tune, invented in the 1990s but hidden from the public as one of the music industry's biggest trade secrets. The effect was eventually championed by T-Pain in the late 2000s, who paid a price for its pioneering style. Backlash, boycotts, and auto-tune bashing became the norm, with artists lining up to protect authenticity from the T-Pain effect. But Pandora's pitch-shifting box had been opened, and the vocal effect didn't just dominate the charts with hit after hit of twisted digital hooks. Instead, the effect became truly ubiquitous, a tool, a virus, a helping hand. In a world where humanity is constantly threatened by its very own inventions, it's no surprise that our singing voice has come to symbolize the final breath of primeval purity. But the relationship between music and technology is deep and symbiotic. While technology may be used to distort our art and culture, music lies in the background, the soundtrack, the jingle, always ready to manipulate our perception of reality. From Meta to Mega Upload, Siri to the Super Bowl, music gives technology and corporations a human face, a casual, approachable personality. An invisible force, unseen but always felt, music is our culture's master manipulator. Bernard Herrmann's strings cut like a knife in Hitchcock's masterful 1960 film Psycho. John Carpenter's DIY score to 1979's Halloween gave his slasher an unsettling persistence. And by 1996, Wes Craven's self-aware scream played with audience expectations, swelling in anticipation of nothing, a new language of irony and anticlimax. In French philosopher Agnès Giraud's 2018 book, Dialectic of Pop, she talks about pop music's complex identity being defined by its very own industry.
Record d'aide populaire musique exhibit certain traits characteristiques of those other great machines d'art, cinema and photography. It was necessary to redefine the idea of the artwork, to displace the classical opposition between original and copy, and the consequence of their mass circulation within industry and culture.
Over the last century, cinema separated itself from theatre, while photography separated itself from drawing and painting. Audiences across the world became connected, not digitally, but mechanically. Replicas and reproductions of previously unimaginable quality. The local cinema with its nationwide blockbusters. The local record store with its collectible vinyl, convenient cassettes, and pristine compact discs. From newspaper to television, art was not just commodified, it was revolutionized. Out of phone networks and military databases, our beloved World Wide Web was born, a whole internet of networked copies. And while technology connects us and binds us, the siren of music charms us, bringing us closer and closer into the net. It's been a while since I've listened to music. Music without computers, music without marketing, music without satellites, music without walls filled with wires and switches. Frankenstein's multimedia monster is alive. A hybrid, a cyborg, a hall of mirrors. An uncanny presence, but a real one. Personal computer music personified. Music and technology are no longer inseparable, no longer soulmates, but simply one soul. It's as if the trickster gods of music always knew. From Weiwei Kyotl to Pan, to Ek and beyond, the art of the muses.
Let the body.
Welcome everyone. The live set will begin shortly. Thank you for choosing PC Spacecraft. For your safety, please remain seated at all times.
Thank you.